Home Assistant 2023.3 is a relatively small release, but still, it is interesting. Let me explain. The first new update that I want to talk about is cleaner entity information dialogs. From now on, if you open an entity for a closer look, you no longer see the usual info, settings and related tabs. They are all now replaced by a cogwheel button and a three dots menu, also called overflow menu. Inside these three dots menu, the related settings can be found as well as the device info. The wheel cog, on the other hand, is the former settings tab. Next new thing in Home Assistant 2023.3 is also an updated look of some dialogs, and these are the lights, switches and siren entities dialogs. Apart from the new look, which is kind of a slider, there are some extra icons in the upper right. The whole idea here is that not all information will be presented on the top of the dialog. Only the most relevant and used one will be shown. And if you need something additional, you have to go to the next level by using the icons. But there are more new dialogs in Home Assistant 2023.3, and the next one is a new Create Automation dialog. If you try to create a Home Assistant automation now, you see that the menu style is different and there are some blueprints aside, including a text saying from where these blueprints are coming. Other than that, creating automation process is exactly the same as before, only this first menu is looking a bit different. A bit different in Home Assistant 2023.3 and onwards is also the restart menu. As the authors are saying, it is now in Windows XP style. If you go to settings and then system, you will find in top right a power icon that when clicked will offer several restart and shutdown options. Have in mind that check YAML configuration before restart is not needed anymore. When you hit restart, YAML is checked automatically for you. Nevertheless, if you still want that YAML check configuration, you can do it from the developer tools. As a worst case scenario, for example, if YAML seems okay, but still there is a hidden issue, there is a safety mechanism that will boot the system in safe mode, from where you'll be able to fix the things. There is also one new option in the restart menu dialog called Quick Reload. Clicking on it is the same as if you go through all of the reloads available in developer tools and click them all one by one. So, a good to know option in my opinion. Next new feature introduced in Home Assistant 2023.3 is the possibility to ask Assist for the current state of the things. Assist is the built-in functionality that allows controlling Home Assistant via text or voice commands. For reference, check this video of mine. So, starting from this release, there are new intents added in Assist. You can now query things about your smart home like how many switches are off and are all doors closed. Have in mind that this functionality depends on the selected language of your Home Assistant. As usual, if you're using English, you should be fine. For other languages, you have to test for yourself. If some of the things are not so okay in your mother tongue, you can contribute. As you know, Home Assistant is an open source software and everyone can add something to make it even better. And here I am talking about Home Assistant contribution, but there is a case that you may not have Home Assistant yet. Here comes the good part. There is a free event coming in the form of a webinar. The host will be one very intelligent and handsome guy who knows a lot about the official Home Assistant installation types. I'm kidding. The host is just me. But I'm not kidding about the webinar. You can reserve your spot for free on this address, and the link is also available in the video description. Next, worth mentioning update in Home Assistant 2023.3 is the extended and improved threat and matter support. For example, Home Assistant Yellow users can enable an experimental threat border router. Users on other systems can get a threat border router using a Home Assistant Sky Connect, for example, or other similar dongle. Auto-discovered configurable entry will be shown in the integration section of Home Assistant. And even if you don't configure Home Assistant as border router, but you have compatible devices from Apple or Google, you'll be able to see them there. Have in mind that Thread is using IPv6 and may not work very well on some routers. If that is the case, you can download the diagnostic data and send it to Home Assistant GitHub as a new issue for further investigation. And that was the threat aspect of Matter, which will improve over time. The other Matter updates is that Matter bridges should now work in this release. That means if you have Philips Hue Hub or Aquara Hub or other compatible, you can now talk to them over Matter and you can expose all of the connected devices of these hubs to Home Assistant that way. Of course, you can achieve the same or even better using the native local Philips Hue Home Assistant integration that is currently available, or by just using the Zigbee devices directly. But that is another topic. For those of you using Home Assistant Core installation type, which is basically Home Assistant running inside Python virtual environment, you can now start using Home Assistant with Python 3.11, which is faster and more efficient than the previous versions. However, update to Python 3.11 is still a work in progress for the Home Assistant container, OS and supervised installation types, but it will be added over time. If some of the terms or abbreviations mentioned in this video are not so clear for you, you can leave the fog by downloading my smart home glossary from my website for free. Inside that glossary, you will find simple and useful explanations that I think will help you in your smart home journey. Thanks for watching, I'm Kiryu, see you next week, bye!